You need rudder while you're rolling.
And then
very little rudder once you're in.
Okay. Yeah, I think I'm getting it.
Yeah, that feels pretty good.
So, rudder, aileron, established, turn. Once we're in the turn, neutralize.
Well, it takes a little bit
just
of rudder.
Just a little bit, right.
Yeah.
That one.
Because the airplane has to continue to yaw a little
right.
bit. So.
Oh, got that P factor.
No. Well, it's not P factor. Just the airplane is, even in a left turn, it's going to require some left rudder when you're
okay.
established in the turn. So. And then how much rudder is a function of how much aileron and how much and what your angle of attack is.
Right.
So, because what you're doing is trying to, when you're rolling into and out of turns, you're trying to compensate for adverse yaw.
Okay.
So, adverse yaw you're doing C1, you're not doing primary training, so adverse yaw, I'm on the controls, you stay there too.
Okay, your controls.
Adverse yaw, but you're on the controls.
Yes.
I'm going to hold rudder, left aileron, nose goes right, right aileron, nose goes left.
Right.
That's adverse yaw. If I increase angle of attack, and I'm going to do that simply by slowing the speed, at a slower speed, now my angle of attack is more.
Uh-huh.
So I'll just fly it here because that's a good speed. Now if I give it aileron, my adverse yaw is much more pronounced.
Really significant, yeah.
Okay?
Definitely.
So here it's going to require more rudder. Like if I wanted to counter this, it takes significant rudder. To stop adverse yaw.
Right.
Whereas if I was going faster, it would take much, or if my angle of attack was higher, it would take much less rudder.
Right. Okay.
So if my angle of attack was lower at a higher speed, it would take much less rudder. So, so for a flight instructor, I would often illustrate it this way. I would show it to you this way. I'm just getting some speed here.
Okay.
I'm just going to do a low G pushover. Here we are. 40. Almost no adverse yaw with full aileron deflection.
Yeah.
That proves that it's not a function of speed.
This is angle of attack.
It's a function of angle of attack.
Okay.
So. You don't get airsick, do you?
No.
Okay. Because what I'm going to do now is pull G's in a turn.
Okay.
At a high speed, and you'll see very pronounced adverse yaw. So here we go, clear left.
Yep.
I'm just going to roll in where we're pulling significant G's. Now give it aileron. So it has lots of adverse yaw.
Yeah.
At high speed. But the difference is we're pulling G's.
Yeah, sharing that load.
Yeah. So adverse yaw is a function of aileron input and angle of attack.
Angle of attack, okay.
But
not airspeed.
Not airspeed.
Yep.
So, okay.
Very cool.
Your controls again.
My controls.
Your controls.
Very cool. Yeah, I like that demonstration.
Yeah, so it sort of helps drive those fundamentals into your brain.
Definitely.
Because you're used to that stuff you have to explain to a primary student.